Wuyi Mountain has some of the best teas in the world. Today we're going to talk about all you need to know about Wuyi teas and share some of my personal story when I visit there annually. Wuyi Cliff Tea, also known as Rock Tea, from northern part of Fujian. Most of the farmers from there have been there for centuries, and their excellence of craftsmanship in making tea was passed down by generations to generation. Teas from this region is classified in three different categories: Wuyi tea, semi-cliff tea, and cliff tea. The primary differing factors is location, altitude of where the tea is found. As you move into higher altitudes, the quality increases. This is due to the optimal seasonal environment, the high oxygen and mineral content. Starting with Wuyi tea, also known as province tea. They are typically grown in an area around the mountain and roasted in big batches. As they are dry in higher temperature, this tea has strong flavor and lingering astringent aftertaste. In a slightly higher mountain altitude, you'll find a tea called semi-cliff tea, or known as half-cliff tea. In this category, the artisanship becomes very crucial. A well-roasted tea at this altitude can rival cliff tea's aroma. This part of mountain features high mineral content, and you can expect a complex texture and sweetness in the tea. Now comes the most exciting one, is the highest altitude. We call it the cliff tea. As the leaves are grown in the National Reserve and Wild Cliff Gorges, access to this tea is quite limited and condition can be quite dangerous due to the climbing involved. They carry an exquisite aroma, full mouth texture, sweetness, and are high in minerals, a true showstopper. One of the most well-known cliff tea is called Da Hong Pao. The original tree still produce about 4 ounces of tea each year, and some of the rare teas are being auctioned to some of the collectors for over 6 digits. So let's talk about how to identify and taste the cliff teas. So what I have in front of me here is I've got the Wuyi tea, semi-cliff, and cliff tea. Traditionally, because those are farm tea in a lower altitude, you can find the leaf a little bit chunkier, thicker, and dry in a high temperature, meant to be keep a little bit longer, because those were more like a staple tea. And we're moving on to more premium tea, they're more delicate, more fine, defined leaves. Now, the high altitude tea, like I said, is more mineral. So when you consume it, there's a method to enjoy that minerally taste. And what it provides you is it maximizes that tinglingness. There's a lot of sensation in your palate. It gives you layers of taste and the sweetness that premium tea leaves provide. So let's give it a try. So I'm just warming up my teapot here. So you can use Gaiwan to brew, or my choice today is terracotta teapot. I can already smell the fragrance. So this one is Yellow Goddess. I pick up a little bit of osmanthus notes. Of course, you always rinse your tea. Now, so the method of drinking tea that has higher in mineral is that you need to slurp it. Now, slurping, I call it a double slurp. A double slurp, basically what you want to do, you want to aerate the tea so the minerals saturates on your tongue. What it gives you is a lot of tinglingness and sweet notes. Some people pick up from the front of the tongue or side of the mouth. There's no wrong answer, it all depends on the individual. But premium tea, you should pick up sweetness. Now, it might take a several practice to how to double slurp. So I would suggest Thank you. I would suggest that you firstly do not slurp first, so you can taste how is it like without slurping. Then you can pick up the differences when you slurp. So first sip is just like normal tea, just sip it. And then the second, when you slurp, just pay a little bit more attention, is when you sip in, you bring the tea in, but you let it fall back out, but with your tea closed. So this is how you do it. It will take several tries, but you'll get it right. Just like that. Very subtle. So this one, I pick up a lot of flowery notes. I pick up sweetness coming in front and the side. Very gorgeous. So keep trying. So again, I'm gonna do one more time. So you wanna inhale. So what you do, sip in. Remember your teeth is closed. A lot of time I find people, the liquid actually drop back out because your teeth are not closed. So make sure you sip in, let it slightly fall back out and bring it back in through your teeth. Now your teeth is actually acting like a sprayer. So the liquid saturates on your tongue. And you, teeth that are high mineral, you should feel tinglingness on your tongue. Excellent tea experience. Give it a try. This farmer from Wuyi Mountain, I was very lucky to meet him in 2008. Of course, as part of the Chinese mannerism, they would treat you for a cup of tea. I sat down with the family, they served me a cliff tea. I didn't know the name at the time. And then, but the first impression that I had was, this is really good tea and remind me so much of what my father used to make me from Fujian. And so immediately I said, I want to bring your tea to Canada. And he said, no, we do not even know how to export. He doesn't even sell his tea outside of Wuyi Mountain, never mind to abroad. So I said, don't worry, I'll take care of the rest. And since then, and he's been supplying tea to us. And one of the very special thing of meeting him is that he's still using a very traditional way of drying the tea. Now traditional is, they dry the tea over charcoal for 11 days. Very labor intensive, because 11 days they dry a little bit. The whole family have different little roasting pan with charcoal underneath. They dry a little bit, they put it aside, let it cool, and then it comes back and then they dry again the next day and through numbers of days. That way the tea is what we call a slow dehydration. Now, slow dehydration gives you the maximum sweetness at the end without bitter notes. So it's a very labor intensive, but worthwhile of doing. And they are very proud of what they produce. Another very cool thing that he does is he only does one harvest. The best harvest is the actually the spring harvest. And the rest of the tea that in the different harvest, what he does is he used the leaf as a fertilizer to feed the tea for the spring. So he said because it's enough to feed his family, he just want to produce the best. So he's one of the very respectful farmer that I've met. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop me a comment below. For more tea content, like, subscribe, and share. Cheers.